Hey everyone, Mr. Newman here. Today we're going to learn about linear inequalities. First of all, I want to give you a graph of 21 minus 3y is less than 9x, and I want you to write down, type down all the things that you notice. I'll give you a second, go ahead. All right, now that you did that, what I want you to do is I want to share with you what I found. I noticed that one side is shaded, and you notice right here, we have an inequality right there. It's not an equal sign, it's a less than or equal to. So that inequality, anytime you have a graph of inequality with an x and a y, you're gonna have to shade one side of the equation, or one side of the line. I also noticed that the line is dashed like this, rather than solid is the other option. So it could be solid or it could be dashed, and we're gonna talk about why that is. Then the line of the graph is 21 minus 3y equals 9x. That's this line right here that's drawn, okay? You would have to make a table or graph it, but you can trust me that that is the line that is graphed. And notice I said that that is the line that is graphed is the equal sign, even though we have an inequality here. The inequality has to do with the fact that it is dashed and the fact that there's a shaded part, more importantly, okay? Last thing I noticed is that this was made in Desmos, and that's just a plug or a helpful hint that if you ever get stuck or if you want to check your work, you can always type that right there into Desmos. 21 minus 3y is less than 9x. And it will graph it for you so you can check and make sure you did everything correctly. So let's actually talk about what are we seeing here. The shaded part are all the points that work for the inequality. In other words, when you plug in x and y, they are the ones that are true for the inequality. So I'm going to show you what I mean by plug them in, and we're going to check and see both graphically and algebraically if some of these points are solutions. So, is 0, 0 a solution? Well, graphically, look at 0, 0. It's right there. It is not shaded in, so it is not a solution. No, because it is not on the shaded side. Any point that is on the shaded side is a solution. Any point that is not on the shaded side is not a solution. Let's check this algebraically also. What do I mean by that? Well, let's write down the equation. We're gonna plug in 0 for x and 0 for y, because 0, 0 has x is 0 and y is 0, and we're gonna see if it's true or not. Well, when I plug in 0 there and 0 there, 3 times 0 is 0, 9 times 0 is 0, and I get 21 is less than 0. Well, wait, 21 is not less than 0. No, so it is not a solution. Anytime that it is not a solution graphically, it will not be a solution algebraically either. All right, let's try 3, 2. Is 3, 2 a solution? Well, graphically, it's sitting right there. That's in the shaded side. So, yes, it is a solution because it is on the shaded side. Let's check algebraically if it's a solution. Well, I know that 2 is my y, so I'm going to put 2 for y. And I know that 3 is x. I'm going to put a 3 in for x. Now that I've plugged those in, let's figure out what those are equal to. 3 times 2 is 6. 9 times 3 is 27. And 21 minus 6 is 15. 15 is less than 27. So yes, this is also a solution algebraically. And like I said, anytime it will be a solution graphically, it will also be a solution algebraically. Well, let's look at 2, 1. Graphically, that point is right there on the line. Huh? What does that mean? Well, let's figure out algebraically to see what's going on here. So if I plug in 1 for x, and then I plug in 2 for y, I'm going to get this, 21 minus 3, and 9 times 2 is 18, so 21 minus 3 is 18. I get 18 is less than 18. Is 18 less than 18? No, it's not. So what's interesting is all the points that are on the line, those are actually all the points that make the, both sides of the inequality exactly the same. And since that's not true, we know that if we have a dashed line and a point is on a dashed line, that means it is not a part of the solution set. So the answer is no. Graphically and algebraically, this is not a part of the solution. If it was less than or equal to, then it would be a part of the solution set, and that would be shown by a solid line. So that's when we have a solid line, if it said less than or equal to, like that symbol. But it wasn't, it was dashed, so that is not a part of the solution set. Let's look at this next problem. I'm going to show you guys how to graph this inequality. First thing you can do is solve for y. I say can because I'm going to show you another way to do that on the back of this paper. But let's start with our inequality, and I'm going to get y by itself. So add 6 to both sides, then divide by 2. Notice I'm dividing or multiplying or dividing with an inequality. We need to check, and if it was negative, if we divided by negative 2 instead, we'd have to flip the inequality from less than to greater than. However, it was positive, so we don't need to flip it. So I get y is less than or equal to, let's see, negative x is negative 1x, so that's going to become negative 1/2x, and 6 divided by 2 is 3, so I get that. All right, step 2 is to tell whether it's dashed or solid. Well, like I mentioned before, a dashed line is when you have greater than or equal or less than. A solid line is greater than or equal to or less than or equal to. So this is going to be solid. Just as a kind of reference to when we did this before, a solid line is kind of like the filled in circle, and a dashed line is kind of like the open circle. The dashed line and the open circle both mean don't include this in the solution set. It's not an answer to your inequality. Whereas a solid line and an open, closed circle means yes, include it in the solution set. All right, step 3, we're gonna graph the equation. Well, I say equation because we weren't given an equation, we were given an inequality, but we've gotta find that line, and the best way to do that is to treat it like an equation. So instead of y is less than, I'm gonna say y is equal to negative 1/2 x plus 3. I know that the y-intercept is 3, and to help you out, you could make a table. That's a good way to graph these. You could also know that negative 1/2 means go down 1 and right 2, rise over run. But I'm going to do this with a table. Notice I picked 2 because if I plugged in 1, I'd get a fraction or a decimal. So I plugged in 2. I got out 2. And I'm going to plot that point. I plug in 4. I get out 1. And so I'm going to plot that point. And now I can connect the dots here because I have a line. Notice I said it was going to be solid, so I made sure to make that solid right there. If I said dashed, I should draw a dashed line instead. Last thing we are going to do is figure out which side of the line to shade. And the way we're going to do that is to check a point. The point I would recommend checking is 0, 0, because that is the easiest point to check. It's the one that's fastest, as you're going to see in a moment here. So I'm going to plug this into this inequality. 0 is less than or equal to negative 1/2 times 0. Oh, that's just 0. And we check and go, okay, is 0 less than or equal to 3? Well, yes, 0 is less than or equal to 3, so we want to shade in the side that has 0, 0. Shade in that side of the line. Well, there is 0, 0, so I'm going to shade in like that below the line. If 0, 0 didn't work in the inequality, then we would shave the other side. We'd shade the top of the line above it. But by checking, we know that's part of the solution set, so we can shade that side. One last comment is you could plug 0, 0 into that original equation, negative 6 plus 2y is less than or equal to negative x, to check your work. In fact, I did that and found I had made a mistake, so I would recommend you doing that as well. Okay, last thing we're going to do is do a kind of word problem here. This equation, notice it says Elijah can spend at most $8.25 on snacks for a party. That at most is very important. In fact, the $8.25 is also important, but the at most we're going to talk about in just a moment. Carrots cost $2 per package, and grapes cost 75 cents per bag. This looks a lot like the problems we did very recently where you have standard form, AX plus BY equals C. I say that because it looks like we're buying carrots and grapes. In fact, it even tells us let X represent the number of packages of carrots, and let y represent the number of bags of grapes. So I'm going to set up the equation that way. 2x plus 0.75y is equal to 8.25. Now, before you write that down, do not write the equals to, because that was back when we were doing equations. This is an inequality, though. It says Elijah can spend at most 8.25. In other words, 8.25 is the biggest numbers can be. Those numbers on the left, 2x plus 0.75y, that's the cost of the party, that has to be less than or equal to 8.25 because 8.25 is the most he can spend. So I'm going to put less than, and because at most means or equal to, that, in other words, you he could spend exactly 825, then I'm going to put or equal to there. Now, we have our inequality. Notice, because it says or equal to, we are going to be drawing a solid line again. And before I let you go and let you try this on your own, I'm going to give you a hint on this one. Because this is set up kind of like standard form, I'm going to do this by plugging in 0 for x and then plugging in 0 for y. And that is going to help me find these points a lot faster. So, label your table header with carrots and grapes. Let's plug in 0 for x. I'm going to do this rather quickly. Notice I did make an equal sign there, but that's just to find our line right now. Divide by 0.75, you get y is 11. And then plug in 0 for y, we get x is going to be, 4.125. Well, we can deal with that. We know how to graph there. It's just a little bit bigger than 4. So let's plot those two points. There's one. I do need to label my axes. There we go. And draw a straight line between those. Great. Last thing we need to do is we need to check a point and shade one side of this solid line. Well, let's try 0, 0, see if it works. So this time, notice I'm writing the inequality, less than or equal to. Notice how fast 0, 0 is, because all that on the left is just gonna be 0, because 0 times anything is 0. So is 0 less than or equal to 825? Yes, it is, so check 0, 0 works, and I'm gonna shade in underneath that line. Now notice I'm not shading to the left or below. That's because you can't really have negative packages of carrots or negative bags of grapes. So I'm just gonna shade inside that triangle there and be smart about where I'm shading. But as long as you shade on the correct side of the line, that's what's most important. Now, this last thing is asking us to give a possible solution and explain what it means in the context of the problem. Whenever it looks for a possible solution or a reasonable solution, just pick a point somewhere that's in the shaded area. I'm gonna pick that point right there, 2, 4. Well, what does that mean? 2, 4 means that that Elijah can buy 2 carrots and 4 grapes. I really mean 2 bags of carrots and packages of carrots and 4 bags of grapes, but you know what I mean. So 2, 4 means he could buy that, and you could do the math and check 2 carrots would only be $4, 4 grapes, 4 times 0.75, would only be $3, so that would only cost $7 total. So he could buy 2 carrots and 4 grapes. In fact, he could buy any of the points in that shaded area and he wouldn't spend too much money. All right, thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something.